Jason O'Neill here from Spectre TV with Pookie Whittington from the Seton Hall team back in 89. Pookie, you were the shortest player in NCAA history back in your day. What kind of, advantage do you think it gives you to kind of come from a different perspective of not being the most gifted kind of physically?
Well, I feel like I am the most gifted physically. I always felt like I had an advantage over anybody that was tall. The ball starts at the ground, and I'm the closest to it. So I put pressure on you 94 feet. I make you feel my strength. I hit you like I'm a 6'4 guy, 6'3 guy, but I'm starting down here at the waist. So I never felt like I was at a disadvantage. I always felt like I had an advantage.
Okay. And then obviously your son is a little shorter as well. Is that something you try and pass on to him as well?
Absolutely. I teach him to play the game as hard as he can. He's got a good feel for it offensively. He's now getting better on the defensive end. He's a junior. He just was 4A player of the year. So he's taking a little bit of that, and he's a grimy kid, you know.
And then you personally, you actually went to a junior college at Ventura College. Shout out to the 805.
That's right.
But is that also something that you can kind of impart to him, that even if you're not going to be a high D1 player, you can still work to get there?
Listen, everybody's journey is different. I teach that if you got a passion for the game, you're going to get better in your own time and own space. If you really love it, you'll go through that being a prep school kid. You'll go through to be a JUCO kid. You might shake out, end up being Division I after 3 years and go in as your junior year. Some kids go in early. It's a lot of guys that never even played high Division I that made it to the league or wasn't even highly touted and went major Division I. So it's really more about how you approach the game, how committed you are, what you're willing to sacrifice to be great.
And then I was reading up on you, and it looked like you've had a lot of success kind of post your basketball career. We were talking with George Raveling a little bit earlier today, and he was talking about developing basketball players on the basketball court and as people, as adults, as men. Is that something that you think is just as important?
It's vitally important. I have a youth program called Team Dream Academy. In order for you to play for us, you have to go to tutoring an hour before practice starts. We have it set up at Rogers Park in Inglewood. So our kids, we prepare them academically as much as we do athletically. And then they have to do some charity work. We work with an organization called Britty Cares that does bedroom makeovers for children that are terminally ill with cancer. And our kids commit to doing whatever it takes to be a kid that's a part of the community. So it's vitally important that the academic side is just as strongly committed as the athletic side.
And then, obviously, Nipsey Hussle just recently obviously made a bunch of news because he passed away and he was really working in his community. You're from Inglewood. Was that something that was just as important to you as the basketball part?
That's where my program is. I live an hour away from Inglewood, and I drive to Inglewood 3 days a week coaching kids who look just like me, who feel just like me, who went through the things that I've gone through growing up on 106 in Doty down in Inglewood. So you got to do that when you can. And I feel like a part of who I am is based on my experience coming from the wood.